Hey Beauty Finders, this is Matthias Allen. Thanks for clicking on my new video. Welcome to Find the Beauty. So on today's episode, I'm gonna take you behind the scenes on a fantastic photo shoot that I'm working on in downtown Los Angeles. I have two male models that I'm gonna take you and show you some very important grooming tips for doing men's makeup for photo shoots, all right? So stay tuned. Now, unlike women, men do not need a full face of foundation. In very rare cases, I will put on a tinted moisturizer or a BB cream over the entire face. But most of the time, I only spot correct men's skin with a very, very pigmented foundation slash concealer. So what I'm going to do is show you that when you just spot correct, you get the best look possible. I'm using the RCMA Foundation Concealer Palette in Shinto, which is a must-have for every professional makeup artist in their kit. It's an incredible product that's been around for decades. It's made with a 50% pigment ratio to waxes and oils for a very high coverage with very little product needed. It also contains no perfumes or lanolin, so it's great for your actor or model skin. It applies like a second skin rather than a heavy coat of foundation. It's also very long-lasting and very little touch-up is needed. Using the Morphe G2 pointed buffer brush is an essential way to help marry the foundation concealer into the entire complexion. You know, let me be clear, I'm not just putting the foundation concealer on pimples or on moles or freckles. I'm actually painting it in small patches around the skin and I'm diffusing it with a sponge. But then going in with this pointed buffer brush is really, really, really amazing because what it does is it just softly diffuses it better than a sponge, and I think even better than a wet beauty blender. I mean, sometimes I think a wet beauty blender is essential when you're using a very heavy cream foundation or a liquid foundation which is very pigmented on a woman's skin, but for men's skin, I think this is the best way to apply a perfect balance of foundation, concealer, and finish. Now the under eye area is always susceptible to creasing, so you want to make sure that you powder it liberally and use a brush that is going to get right underneath the eye. Then for the forehead, you can go in and use a larger powder brush and more of a mattifying powder, something with rice or cornstarch. That would be my suggestion. Next, I'm going to show you the Lise Wattier Cosmetics Bronzer, which is fantastic for just adding a little bit more color under the neck and down onto the chest. This has a little bit of shimmer and sheen, and the IT Cosmetics All Over Powder Brush number 211 is one of my favorites. I like a lot of different brush lines, and the Delium Tools and the Morphe brushes are for you shoppers out there who want to save a little bit of money. They're very, very, very well-made brushes, and they're very inexpensive. And the IT Cosmetics brushes are a little bit more luxurious, and they're a little bit more high-end, so they're going to cost a little bit more, but definitely worth it as well. Every model that you have in your chair is going to have slightly different skin, and when I surveyed the skin texture of my second model, I made the decision to hydrate. I could tell he was a little bit dehydrated. He had a few more crow's feet and lines than the first model, so I went in with the Murad Acne Complex Pore and Line Minimizing Hydrator. This moisturizer has kombucha collagen, which smooths the appearance of fine lines and wrinkles, while lentil seed extract and witch hazel tighten the pores. It also has a little bit of a silicone slip and ingredient in it, which makes it a perfect base for other foundations and concealers to glide on. When grooming a model or an actor, pay attention to their nose hairs as well as their eyebrows or ear hairs. You know, it's something that a lot of people pass up, but I have a very detailed eye, and I know that even if it's not a beauty story where the camera may not be extremely close up, I don't want any nostril hairs to become a problem later on when the photographer is looking at the shots in post. Also, make sure that you get rid of any kind of caterpillars going on in the middle, no monobrow. Make sure that you know how to tweeze brows without making them look like a woman, and just give them the best grooming possible. This goes for straight beard hairs. If they haven't trimmed their beard in the last week and you feel like you want to use a pair of scissors or grooming shears to trim their beard. These are things that you want to pay attention to if you're going to be a great groomer and you're going to be the best at your job. Now, I don't know about you, but past the late 20s and into my very early 30s, I noticed that my eyes look tired, and I really prefer to have a nice bright eye, no matter if it's a man or a woman. So I pay attention to placing concealer on the eyelid as well as under the lash line. I want my actor or model to look bright and fresh, okay? So that is something you should definitely think about when you are looking at your face to perfect. Now, my final pro artist tip for men's grooming is this. It's safer to go light than it is to go dark. As you can see, his face is very bright and light, and it's much easier to use a finishing powder like the Urban Decay Ultra Definition powder in medium to just give him a little bit more depth on the temples and on the cheekbones than it would be to try and highlight after the foundation or concealer is already on. Okay, so always try using a loose powder that is a little bit deeper than your actor's skin tone to deepen up any kind of lightening that's happening on the face. It's much easier than going the opposite way. Thanks so much for watching this video, you guys. I really enjoyed sharing my tips and tricks with you. Now, please subscribe to my channel because I have a link right here for you to subscribe. I do weekly makeup demos, beauty hauls, product reviews, and step-by-step makeup instructions. I would love for you guys to follow me on Instagram and Twitter at MathiasForMakeup. And I always post behind the scenes photos, and I would love for you to follow me on there. Also, leave me any comments you have about any products I use or any demonstrations that you want to see in the future, because I love hearing from my fans and followers. My passion is beauty and educating my subscribers on how to use specific products in detailed step-by-step tutorials featuring blondes, brunettes, young, and mature. I want to help you achieve the celebrity red carpet ready appearance that I've been perfecting throughout my career. I have a weekly series called Monday Makeup Chat where I talk about what's new in beauty or sit down with fellow artists and discuss current beauty trends or how to become a freelance artist. My other series is called Fierce Face Fridays and covers everything from avant-garde to full-out drag queen transformations every single week.